Hi, my name is Jeff H. Seif from PracticeInterviews.com. In this video, we are going to tackle the account strategist interview. Why? Because we are getting a ton of clients this year for these roles, especially at Google, and they're tricky roles, and we want to really uncover some tips and tricks that are going to help you have success. Now, going in, you really need to understand how the holistic piece is going to play out here. So obviously, communication and collaboration is key. Now we need to be thinking about both internal and external stakeholders. You have to know the product space and the offerings and strategies attached to those products. And then lastly, we're really going to look to correlate all this information with great data and metrics. And we're going to tackle all this, and then we're going to do a sample question at the end. We'll do a sample open-ended question wearing the hat of a Google account strategist. If you like my content, please like. If you have any comments, please comment below. And if you like my overall content, please subscribe. Item one, product. Let's dive right into this subject. No matter what the product is, you have to really have a strong understanding of the product space. So let's take a very common role, an account strategist role at Google. Do you know that there are 7 different types of campaigns, from the basic stuff we know like search and display and YouTube to shopping, apps, local campaigns, smart campaigns? There's a lot. So you need to kind of learn the product space and have that passion. Why is that important? Those candidates that are really interested in their clients having success, that's what success is going to look like in an account strategist interview. And what I often hear from clients is, hey, the recruiter said it's cool if I don't know the product space. Here's the challenge. Your competitors are going to either take the time to learn it, or they might have been working with something like Google Ads for the last 3 years with their company. So just know that if you don't up your product knowledge, your competitor is going to. So let's paint a really, really simple scenario for you. I want you to imagine your interviewer, Sue, it's always Sue, has back-to-back interviews for an account strategist role. Well, if you go in and you kind of keep it high level, you touch on some basic items, but you don't really get into the weeds, and then Sue's next interview is with Jane, and Jane absolutely crushes it, gets into massive depth in her answers, well, Sue's going to hire Jane every time, because when she's having the conversation with Jane, Jane's not only building massive connectivity, but Sue's envisioning Jane in the role, because Jane feels like a colleague, not like a candidate. And so that's really, really critical for you to know. It will be a totally different experience if you do this. So learn the product space. And one of the items I recommend is, if you're watching this video and you have that interview in 2 days and you don't feel prepared, just reach out to your recruiter and ask if you can push. Interviewers are never going to be upset that they don't have an interview on their calendar. If there's multiple openings, see if you can push. You should be a product, not expert, but you should be pretty knowledgeable. Item two, strategy. So this directly correlates with the product. The only way that you're going to really benefit and be able to work with the client is to build in that second layer of connectivity. So what do I mean by this? Let's stick in the ad space, for example. Well, not all clients are going to want to focus on the same thing. So the strategy might really be around brand awareness. It might be just straight up sales. It might be customer acquisition, like you're trying to get them in the funnel and keep them in the funnel. They're all different strategies. And whatever it might be, if you can couple the product knowledge with then implementing the strategy that a client might care about, whatever the product might be, that correlation and combination, it's going to be awesome for your success. Item three, client needs. So believe it or not, this is actually the area that I spend chatting with my clients about the most. Why? Because we kind of know the product, we maybe know the strategy, and we know that we got to think about their needs and their goals and objectives and all that important stuff. But then when we answer the questions, whether it's on the open-ended side or behavioral side, we don't really talk about these items, and we need to be focused on questioning, listening, providing that empathetic lens, understanding whether they're resourced appropriately, whether they have the right training in place, what are the support systems that we can provide so that they can be successful. This piece is actually feedback that I've heard recruiters giving to candidates going into Google. So really have that client needs lens and talk a little bit more about it in your answers. Item four, internal. Okay, this is a fun one. And while these roles are external focused and we should kind of get our brain into that space, the reality is that half the work is being done internally. And so there's two really specific areas I want you to focus in on your open-ended answers and behavioral answers, which is talking about the internal stakeholders that you collaborate with, likely the product team and eng team, so that you can share learnings and grow together. And then the second piece is just these overall internal projects, which are probably going to be very process oriented, systems oriented. There's going to be some strategy involved, but these roles are not just external focused, and just having a 100% external lens isn't going to give, again, that holistic picture like we talked about in the beginning. Item five is metrics and data. So during this interview, all I want you to do is continue to talk about data and metrics. And obviously, if you're talking about it internally and externally, it's going to be great. But you want to talk about things like use cases, how you present information, that presentation skills are really important. If you're going to bring up percentages, make sure they're backed by numbers. And I think another data point that I love is all this like surveying information. How can we gather data from the customer base to learn and therefore help the client? So data and metrics are just going to be awesome for you. Item six is career path. I just wanted to touch on this briefly. Why I like these positions so much is they're a real door opener. Account strategists are typically going to be entry to mid-level roles. And what they do is they allow you to maybe grow into just an account management role. So you're just growing within the position, but then you could go over to sales. You could go over to the product side, even program management, because you're wearing so many hats, you're juggling a lot of items at one time. So it's a really cool role to get into, and you'll learn a great skill set and you'll learn a ton of client skills. You work with clients of lots of different sizes, lots of different industries, typically in these types of positions. Okay, let's dive into our sample example. So I want to tackle an open-ended question just to cast a little bit of a wide net. So we got to get a little position specific here. So I'm going to imagine that I'm interviewing with Sue for an account strategist role at Google, and it's pretty generic, meaning that there's no size of company target and no specific industry target either. Let's pretend that Sue asks us the following question. Jeff, I want you to imagine I'm the marketing manager for XYZ Corp. How would you help me? Okay, Sue, I'd like to ask a few clarifying questions, and the first two questions are pretty basic. I just want to understand if XYZ Corp is an existing Google Ads client, yes or no, and then I would want to understand as well my relationship. Do I have a previous relationship with this marketing manager, or we have no formal relationship? We've been in a relationship for over a year, so just understanding Google and my relationship with this client. What I'd also like to know, Sue, is I also would like to know the size. So are they an SMB or enterprise company? I definitely want to understand the industry, whether they were more regulated like finance or healthcare, or a little bit more flexible like e-commerce. And then I'd want to know a little bit more about their ads journey. Like, have they used Google Ads before? Have they used Facebook ads, other types of ads, just their ads journey in general? And then lastly, would just be their primary focus. Is it focused more on sales or branding, for instance? Sue, I know I said a few questions. That was about six questions. Can you help clarify any of those items for me? Okay, Sue, based on the limited amount of information we have, here are some high-level items I would really like to focus on with this marketing manager at XYZ Corp. Goals and objectives. I gotta look at that historical data. I have to understand their appetite for their budget, for the costs. I want to know how they're internally resourced, so that's really correlated with stakeholders. And then lastly, again, just understanding the overall scope and scale. Now, I think a fun area to start with would be really capturing that historical data, but I'm going to pause. Is there any specific area that you want me to focus on? Okay, let's start with that historical data component, and let's make a couple of assumptions. I want to assume that they are an existing company. Let's assume they're an athletic clothing company, for example, and that existing relationship with Google, but not with me, and their main target is sales and growth of month over month sales, for example. The first step we would need to take is really understanding if the client gets the platform. So do they understand how to utilize ads? Do they understand all the data and analytics? Do they have the right resources in place? And can we create a strong training and development program for them? That's going to be really critical before we dive in. Let's assume we establish all those items and then we want to dig into the previous campaigns. Let's say they were doing a ROAS campaign. We want to look at the data and metrics. And then of course we want to look at the keywords that they're utilizing as well. And based on what we're seeing with current trends in the e-commerce space, especially during COVID, we might want to stick with that automated bidding for shopping campaigns, but maybe we flip it over and we do an enhanced cost per click. So we're still going to focus on getting those live conversions, getting those real conversions, but we're going to take a little bit different strategy and a little bit different approach. Okay, so let me pause there. We can get a lot more into the enhanced cost per click piece and how we might navigate through that with this e-commerce company, or we can flip over and talk a little bit more about budget. What do you prefer? Okay. And we'll stop there. And you notice I built in some pauses. That's very intentional. We want to build in pauses and give our interviewer, Sue, space to come in. And yes, this was pretty high level. The clarifying questions, there was a lot. The framework was very high level and the solution kind of just started to scrape the surface. Remember, ideally in open-ended questions, we're going to create a dialogue and a back and forth and we're going to have multiple solutions overall. These are exciting positions, and I hope that just a little bit of this information gives you the foundation to help you have success. So go prep, learn the product space, but don't forget about the collaborative lens, internal and external. Really think about the people skills. It's a hybrid. We really have to understand the product space and understand how to work with others. I hope this helps. Good luck.